Vanessa Zamora here. Joining me now is Alex Volk. He is the search marketing director at a little company you might have heard of. It's called Microsoft.
It is.
Thanks for joining us today.
Glad to be here.
Excellent. Okay, so interesting job you got there. You've got to wrangle a bunch of SEOs, I guess. And what does a typical day look like for you when you get to the office in the morning?
Well, there's no one typical day, but ever since I started this practice 4 years ago, it's really been about staying on top of what's going on in the business, figuring out where the biggest opportunities are for us to make impact, and really focusing and being strategic on the things we go after to drive maximum impact. Because there's probably 100 times as many things as we want to do that we can. So we just got to be focused in on it, and that's really, I think, has been our secret to success.
And what are some of the challenges that your team is facing right now, be it internally or, with dealing with the ever-changing and ever-evolving search space?
Well, there's a lot of challenges. One of the biggest ones for us is keeping up with all the content. Microsoft.com basically has an infinite amount of content in it. And so figuring out how we retire content and have a content lifecycle policy is big for us because we just keep cranking more stuff out without thinking about the things that are already there. Other things are the just enterprise or site-wide initiatives, anything from standard redirect policies to how we handle localization, and really trying to build things once that you can deploy across a number of different things so that you can see the impact in every single time that process or solution actually comes together and runs.
So you spoke on a session this morning on in-house SEO training. In-house SEO training, is that the
Correct.
Session title? What are some of the takeaways from that session?
Well, there were a number of them. One of the big takeaways we had was start by building a framework. And we've got an SEO framework in the slides that anybody can take and use and make their own. And the idea is understand all the areas that you can touch and the areas of SEO that you actually control within your business. Then really think about, of all those things, what's the opportunity analysis you can conduct to say, here's the prioritized list of things I want to go after. Then you find the low-hanging fruit, really chase after those things, show some success, document it with results, build a case study, and then use that as your rallying cry to do bigger and better things the next time around. And you build momentum and scale that way.
What are some of the tools that you use? I don't know if you use any in management, but specifically your SEOs to assist you.
First off, everybody should build a dashboard. You really want two of those. One, an executive level dashboard that contains 3 to 5 core metrics around SEO. Those are the things you let everybody in the organization look at, especially the C-level and senior managers. Then you deliver a line-level dashboard, and that's really for anybody in the organization that touches SEO on a daily basis. Give them the rich metrics and the customized stuff that they need to be successful. So build those scorecards first. Then I think what you can do is actually look at incremental tools and things that augment your processes. We happen to use an SEO tool called BrightEdge that's actually a third-party solution that brings in a lot of rich data from the search engines themselves, also consumes site-side analytics tools like Omniture and Web Trends, and really gives you a robust picture of what's going on. That'll allow you to chase smaller opportunities as you really nail the big things and your list and your backlog tends to shrink.
What exciting things do you think are on the horizon for the search?
Well, I think certainly social signals is really interesting. If you look at the way in which social content is starting to permeate search engines, be it Bing or Google, it's fundamentally changing how content gets represented in search. And I think often as SEOs, we only think about our own site, when in fact we really need to be thinking about how people are speaking about us, because that more and more often is becoming part of the results. And people tend to trust results that come from someone you know. And so thus, I really think we have to take a step back and think about how social is really changing the landscape of SEO and how it's going to change the content that we touch.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Alex. This is Alex Volk of Microsoft. I'm Vanessa Zamora. Thank you for your time.
Thanks a lot.